Mr. Speaker, sir, I am grateful to you for giving me this opportunity to speak on a very realistic budget presented in Parliament. I am sure the people of Gujarat are going to join me in congratulating the government for saving them from a high dose of taxation as was proposed by the previous government in the state. Stop. Sir, I take this opportunity of mentioning a few things more which I would not probably have been able to do, as these are the state subjects. Stop. Before the state government gave up power, the central government has, of course, not imposed the president's rule, but we are under the governor these days. Hence, the state's budget was presented. Stop. Sir, I do not know whether it has been an oversight by the administration today or whether they have carried on what the previous government had mentioned. I would like to be very specific here in mentioning about the sales tax that they have imposed on all fish and marine products in Gujarat. Stop. I do not understand the logic behind it. Stop. As far as Gujarat is concerned, we have bigger coastline than any other state in India. Stop. Our maritime resources have not been exploited fully. Stop. Our fishery industry has still not reached the stage which could be compared with even the backward states of this country, who are also maritime states. Stop. These are other states like Kerala, where the fishery industry has developed long ago and it has come to take off stage, where from the inshore fishing they have now gone to offshore fishing. Stop. Even in those states where 50% of marine products are exported, they do not have sales tax on fishing and marine products. Stop. The Gujarat government expects a revenue of about rupees 40 lakhs to rupees 50 lakhs by way of sales tax. Stop. I am sure that they are going to ask you also that these taxes should be imposed on the traders and on the fishermen and not on industries. Stop. We know that whenever such a tax is imposed, it goes down to the fishermen. Stop. The fishermen in Gujarat are poor. Stop. We recently had an example of the export duty levied on all wool that was exported. Stop. There too, Gujarat was affected. Stop. The argument given at that time was that this export duty was expected. There too, Gujarat was affected. as such stop.